Hello everyone, I am Sajjad and you are watching Pharma Inform. Today we will discuss a very important topic, which is functions of HVAC. In this video, basically we will learn about the use of heating, ventilation and air conditioning system in pharmaceutical industries. We will also discuss the functions of HVAC for homes or other buildings, but first we will discuss the functions of HVAC in the pharmaceutical industries. In this video, we will learn how HVAC in pharmaceutical industries works and how we can achieve clean rooms in pharmaceutical industries by using the HVAC system. So we will discuss basic functions of HVAC in this video. So HVAC system is used to control the temperature. Mean in a pharmaceutical industry, suppose if we take the example of granulation area, the workers working in granulation area required a specific temperature control environment for the smooth working. Apart from the operators or workers or official staff working in the manufacturing area, the products which we are manufacturing in the area also require the specific and controlled temperature. So HVAC system is used to control the area of the room either by cooling system, mean to provide the cool air, or to provide the heat air by using the heating system. So in simple words, HVAC system in pharmaceutical industries is used to maintain the temperature of a area or a room. It is also used to the controlled humidity, mean HVAC system which we use in pharmaceutical industries provide us a controlled humidity level. The main or technical function is the to develop differential pressure. Mean HVAC system is used to develop a differential pressure. What is differential pressure? How it works? We will discuss in detail in our airlock system. But for a brief overview, basically between a working area, we have a buffer and then we have a corridor. So to develop a pressure between primary working areas and buffer, we have to develop pressure positive or negative between those two areas to prevent the cross contamination. Mean in one area we can create a positive pressure area and in second room or buffer room we can create a negative pressure room or positive pressure room. It depends upon the class or grade A, B, C, D way where we maintain our inside or outside according to the requirements. If we take the example of class D or oral solid dosage form manufacturing area, as we know in granulation area, primary area have negative pressure, so buffer will be positive. Mean we have developed a differential pressure between primary area and buffer area. So this differential pressure help us to prevent cross contamination or to prevent the dust. Mean if we develop a proper differential pressure between two areas, this differential pressure help us to prevent the cross contamination and it protects our products. Cross contamination can affect our product quality. We will discuss in detail in our airlock video how differential pressure system works and how it works to prevent the cross contamination. So this system is also used to maintain air changes, mean In a pharmaceutical industry, as you know, that we require a proper and certain amounts of air changes in a specific area. So those air changes are supplied by the HVAC system. We will discuss how to calculate air changes in a separate video to achieve clean room. As you know, in our previous video, we discussed clean rooms. If you have not watched, the link is given in description. For clean rooms, we have certain requirements. So to meet those requirements, we use HVAC system. HVAC system is used to control the number of viable and non-viable particles inside the pharmaceutical industries. For this, we use different types of filters, and we also use air changes system to control the particle count. So it was a brief overview of HVAC, why we use HVAC in pharmaceutical industries. We use it to control temperature, we use it to control humidity, simply we use it to develop a differential pressure, we use it to prevent cross contamination, we use it to provide certain amount of air changes, we use HVAC to achieve clean room area status, we use HVAC to control the particle count, viable and non-viable in our manufacturing areas. Now we will discuss the functions of HVAC for normal living homes or for the living buildings. Basically, for homes or living buildings, HVAC system is used to provide environmental comfort for the residents of the building. Means the system is used to control the temperature and humidity of the building and also supplies the fresh air to the residents of the building. So for homes, the HVAC system provide required level of oxygen. It removes carbon dioxide from the building or rooms, and it is also used to remove the excess of humidity or fumes from the building or kitchens, and it is also used to remove the odor or smell from the rooms or from the buildings. So hope you are now clear with the concept of functions of HVAC in the pharmaceutical industries and in the homes or buildings. If you like our video, you must subscribe our channel and press the bell icon button so that you can easily and on the priority basis can receive our upcoming videos. Share the video to others. First must subscribe PharmaInform.